In one of my previous videos, I covered how much print quality you can gain by simply printing the outer wall first before the adjacent inner wall is printed. The results were truly game-changing, but the same was true when comparing two different extruder types of single versus dual drive gears. Bambu Lab P1S with a single drive gear extruder produced basically flawless looking prints compared to my fully modded KP3S Pro, which had a dual drive gear extruder. So I decided to dig deeper and to test the Orbiter V2, Galileo 2, P1S and A1 mini extrusion consistency. I made multiple test prints and used the worst lighting angles to expose those irregular layers. So let's find out if we should be concerned with our dual drive gear extruders and if single drive ones are the way to go. To test the Orbiter V2 and Galileo 2 extruders, I had to design a different mounting solution as my 3D printer had a BMG extruder mount. A significant reason why I decided to do this comparison is that these two extruders have the same mounting points. That makes easier to change and more properly compare the capabilities of single versus dual drive gears. This time I decided to challenge myself and design a bracket that could be 3D printed from plastic and be as rigid as from aluminum. All the plastic parts for the project and the Galileo 2 extruder were manufactured by today's video sponsor PCBWay from glass filled nylon using SLS 3D printing. So if you need high quality plastic parts that have higher rigidity and can withstand higher levels of heat or any other professional services, make sure to check them out. For the first test prints, I used Bambu Lab 0.2mm hot end as this printer has a bolt screw and Z-axis movement precision is the most precise from any printer I have. However, the initial results were quite disappointing. Using Mihai Design's extrusion consistency test print, neither extruder produced a good looking print and both looked almost the same. As this was printed with a 0.2mm nozzle in vase mode and the extrusion width was only around 0.3mm, the whole print had signs of warping. That introduced additional inconsistency, so I decided to try printing in a regular mode using free walls, but yet again the results showed no difference between two extruder types. I also made a custom test print with a smaller angle and a shorter walls to reduce the warping, but again both test prints with dual and single drive gear extruders looked the same. Printing in regular mode yet again made no difference whatsoever. At this point I decided to ditch the 0.2mm hotend and install the 0.41 because it seems that both extruders are not the bottleneck using the smaller nozzle. I also decided to introduce two other 3D printers just for sanity's sake. So I also made test prints on Bambu Lab's P1S which has a dual drive and A1 mini which has a single drive gear extruder. So can we finally see the difference? I would say yes. Test prints with single drive gear extruders look definitely more consistent, but dual drive ones perform nowhere as badly compared to the provided samples where we could very easily see the artifacts that would indicate real mechanical problems with a dual drive gear extruder. If I had to rank this group of prints from best to worst, it would be the A1 mini, then Galileo 2, P1S and the last Orbiter V2. We also must keep in mind that all these shots are in the worst lighting conditions and you will never see this with regular lighting unless you decide to start peeping on your prints with a flashlight. The next set of test prints told the exact same story. Both single drive gear extruders had more consistent layer lines. Only this time P1S extrusion consistency looked worse than Orbiter's. But when we have such small differences, I feel like we're just choosing the random patterns we prefer individually. So let's rather move to the next test print, the good old cylinder in vase mode. This one still remains my favorite as it is way less prone to warping and introducing unwanted variables. The only addition I made to it was to flatten the back so it wouldn't roll around and we would see the same angle of a front face. This time the print by A1 mini stood out quite far from others, in fact considering the harsh lighting it looked just flawless. Galileo extruder took the second place followed by Orbiter V2 and the P1S. While both single drive gear extruders had more consistent extrusion than dual drive ones, I expected Galileo 2 results to be on par with the A1. I even started to doubt if the printer's motion system was good enough. You see, this printer has a ball screw that is extremely rigid and is firmly mounted to the gantry, meaning that any wobble of it could be transferred to the X-axis, especially as this is cantilevered for the printer. While the motion of a Z-axis felt very smooth, I still additionally made sure that the ball screw nut could slightly move by adding spring washers and not fully tightening the screws. This meant another rerun of test prints. So was this the problem after all? Well, no. The first round of test prints showed no difference whatsoever. Orbiter V2 and Galileo 2 before and after the fix, results haven't changed in the slightest. The second round of test prints yet again told the same old story, indicating no wobble to be present. The third and final round of test print completely sealed the deal and eliminated any worries, as there was no difference in layer consistency when comparing Orbiter V2 and Galileo 2 before and after the fixed results. However, I still checked if there was any wobble with a runout gauge by moving the z-axis along a stationary steel right angle square, but the results, once more, showed no problem being present. So do all these test prints confirm that single drive gear extruders are just better? If you are chasing those perfect layer lines for your practical prints, I would say yes. Dual drive extruders and their never perfectly meshing gear problem is engraved into their design and will probably never go away because we can't manufacture perfect parts to eliminate that. However, please don't get me wrong, high quality dual drive gear extruders are still perfectly viable because in real printing scenarios we introduce a lot of other variables that narrow the visual layer consistency gap. So the final print quality improvement you will get depends on how good the rest of your 3D printer is. When looking at these two different single drive gear extruders, you can see how much more complex the Galileo 2 is than the A1 series extruder. The more moving parts, the harder it is to ensure surgical precision, as every part won't be perfect and will adapt to the overall inconsistency. Keeping it as simple as possible is probably the main reason why A1 series extruder performs so well. But one thing that you must consider when going the single drive route is the filament being more prone to higher slip and deformation, as we lose so much more surface area to grip it. That shouldn't be a problem if you leave a generous flow rate headroom for the hot end to properly melt the filament, but for example, if you use tiny nozzles, the required extrusion force increases substantially and you will be more limited by how well the single drive gear can grip the filament rather than the max flow rate. That is the main reason why we'll go with the Orbiter V2, because this printer is dedicated to small prints with a small 0.2mm nozzle. I hope in the future we'll see more single drive gear extruders that can be just as simple and effective as the A1 series. After all these test prints, I kinda want to try installing it on non-Bambu Lab printers or even try designing my own. Not sure if that will happen, but if it will, make sure to be subscribed not to miss it. What is your opinion about all this? Will you be going the single drive gear route on your 3D printer? Or you have already gone that route and you want to share your experience? Feel free to leave a comment below. Huge thanks to all the Patreon and YouTube members for your continued support. Well, that's all from me, and we'll see you next time.